a little slower looking at it another time. And on page Kufayin Dalet, the Ambir Maimer Merazor Parshat B'Shalach. So he says, "Ubezeh tisboyer l'chol lashon maimer echad misefer azoyer beparshat b'shalach v'daf esera be'inyan kriyas yamsuf v'pasuk ma titzach olai." So this apparently is a theme right here for the next little time we're going to look over this. And he says, "Ma titzach olai ba'omer rash be'gabalav shalom b'hai milo lo sisha." No, never ask about this. So tinase es Hashem, and don't test Hashem. The question is, what does it, you know, what does this phrase mean? So I know that Rabbi Wein, in his, you know, one of his drushes, he really translates the word ma as my. Why are you crying out to me? Now maybe that makes sense, but here ma is actually the name of Zeranpin. That's my thinking. I just wonder. He's a ma titzak a lot. So what is the, is it calling out to me? Something like Ma is calling out to me, crying out to me. Bama Rashbi, he says that this is a question, this is something you shouldn't get into. Vavada should be a mimer, so certainly that you can get into the Chazer of Amuk Ma'od is extremely, extremely deep. Habakavin Shemitzini, the Rashbi, Chalav Shalom, Shehifli Bechastaris Soda, that he was very, I guess he wants to make sure that this is, the secret of it is hidden. Vamra behind Mila Lo Sishal, and he said, don't ask about this. Now I'm going to move over to the next page, and page Kuf Ayin He. And he says, Paprat Yesh de Zalkar Kushaose Beinian Mochin de Katnas. Now he comes out, what are Mochin de Katnas anyway? Vizekha Patam Mises Ben the Rizal. And then he wants to come in, and he said, this is the reason why the son of the Rizal died. The reason why, when he said this, where he said, don't ask about this, he says, so he says, now what? So I'm trying to think. I've made my own answer. What is mochim the katnas really mean? So mochin dekatnis, I think, means lust. I think it means just physicality, pure physicality. Ki heim dinim dekifim, they're very strong dinim. But yosa ande misazik besodas haTorah, when a person gets himself involved in learning Torah, im yihya beinyan zman hagadlus elyon. So if you're talking about the godless elyon, the godless, right? O b'shar drashi hachmas emes or anything else. Shehein in Yan in the Mala, which really refers to Olam Atzilus and what's going on in the origins of reality. Ein la Adam kol kach sechana, a person's not really that much danger. Danger gemosher bezan she'osei besodas zman ad katnas. It's different. Gibis asko behem, hinech yitzoynim is ordinim behem, but it's askim sham, and they grab a hole there. The maskirim of a noisiv shall adam amis asek behem, and they say this, they start getting into the different sins of the person. So let's read a little bit more. He says, "Yizboyer beer akasev v'yanez Moshe mifonav." So now, what's this all about? Moshe ran this, talked about this. He threw down his rod. V'zera v'sod Moshe rabbeinu all of shem rabban shall neviim. Shamba bo b'yanes Moshe b'fonav, and Moshe fled from before it. V'ratam hu, and the reason is the fisha inyan amita, asher anehafach lenachash, hu b'b'chinas katnas zer anpin anikra nachash. So the phrase is he says that the mate that he threw onto the ground and turned it into a snake is the aspects of the katnas zer anpin, which is called nachash. So think back to Adam and Eve when we first got the vision of the nachash over there, getting involved in it. So my way of understanding it is that it has to do with pure lust. But he's going to work it. Gemosh avoyer be'ezes Hashem, as we're going to explain. So once he sits, he's dealing with that rush. He started to deal in that rush. Now, according to the Torah, he's standing in front of Paro. And according to this, he's really actually dealing with something very deep. He became very, very frightened as a result of it. Vayanis mifonav, and he's talking about the nachash again, which he said, what is the nachash? Between the because the notness the nachash represents continence. So therefore, what the secret is over here, we got to hide it. If it's because of itself, or because, let's say, we don't know the truth of it. Even a grain of mustard grain, it's very small, from that drush that we've been giving over here. And now let's go back and look at this again. Let's go for another couple of minutes here. We'll just do a couple more, and then we'll go over to the sifra that's the Yotam Hashem. So let's try to understand this. My titzak a line. What's wrong with that? So I looked at the Ela, they translate as a hind. I think a hind, I'm not sure, some kind of four-legged animal. So where's this coming from? He says that he has a very narrow womb. And she's extremely loved by her husband. Now when she gives birth, and maybe we've seen this in other mizdamen law, nachash echad, so there's a waiting for her as she gives birth, a certain, what's the word, a serpent, Venoshech ba'aryasa violetis, and it bites her at the place of her erva, and she gives birth. Now that phrase, I actually took the time and I looked it up over here in the Gemara and Baba Basra. It talks about the first thing is it talks about, which doesn't make any sense either, is that a mountain goat gives birth to a child, to a whatever is a kid. And it falls off the mountain, and just at the right moment, an eagle comes by and picks it up. Then it goes over to this one. Now that one isn't explained over here, and it could use some explanation. So we're talking about the hind, this animal, which has a very narrow, narrow womb. So what does this mean? So what are we talking about? So he says, Yizboyer Inyan Ha'elo V'Hakeshe V'Amochen the Pesach. So this is going to be, we're going to stop after this one. Daki Ha'elo, this animal, this hind, he, the Nukva de Zeranpin. It's a metaphor for the Nukva of Zeranpin. Ha'chaviv V'Me'od Al-Baila, which is Zeranpin, who is really desired object or whatever the price is, very desired by Zeranpin. And this is the situation at the first night of Pesach. Zer Anfin and the Nukva have a Yichud. This was a tremendous high. This is a Yichud of Godless, and it's a tremendously high Yichud. The Fisherazah Nigdal Batachlis of Godless, because Zah, he grows, he starts to grow, and the ultimate idea is to grow Zah. So also the aspect of Yisod that has the Yichud, where the Yichud takes place, are the Oz Imo, who sowed the godless. So that exchange of Chasadim and Gevuros over there is a time of godless. But the Yisod Zivug, who is Zivug, Elyon V'lo Na'aza of Yedenu. So it doesn't even happen by us. It happens by itself. Nasarno B'Zivug Tachton. So therefore, we were forbidden from having yichud at that time, kenizka the ale. Now, I think that's what Nasarno means. So it comes out like this, that the nuk becomes impregnated through this process and remains impregnated all the days of Pesach. Now, when you come to the seventh day of Pesach, which is the crossing of the Yam Suf, shall Pesach yoledes so she gives birth. So it's like splitting maybe the Red Sea a little bit. He's got an interesting different definition of the word sof over here later on, and suf, which I think he translates it as sof. V'ayim bedras yom Israel chag ashal sukos. He says sham nizbayer beofen acher. So that's it for today. So let's say today is the 23rd of Iyar. All right, let me stop that. We'll come over to the sif.